I've always found myself obsessed with birds, lizards, and all these different things, and as part of the landscape. Increasingly, I'm realizing that what I'm trying to do is that I am a kind of endangered species because I'm painting poor old endangered species. The intriguing thing about godwits is that they breed all up in the tundra, in the northern hemisphere, sort of Manchuria, all the way up there. And then every year they travel 12,000 kilometers, sometimes non-stop. And that in itself is such a magic and mysterious thing. These birds do this because the whole world has evolved to have certain kinds of systems that work. So these are really interesting stories if we're talking about the big things that are happening to the world in a way. You see, I'm not a climate denier. I actually know that extraordinary things are happening in the natural world which are just simply have not been happening in the last many thousands or even million years. So much of life now is in little boxes. The scientists think they're over there, and the artists are over there. The most exciting things are when they come together. The intriguing thing is, will that message come through when there's a people going this way and that way? Can the still small voice of the person saying something about the power of beauty and nature survive the city? And in fact, the city now is taking over. What are the wellsprings of why we do this thing? For me, personally, it comes back to an absolute obsession and love with wild landscape.
I like it, particularly because it's the colour, and it's such a contrast to the greyness of the buildings around.
It's really natural. A lot of city art seems to be reflecting the city back onto itself with just lots of layers of people and concrete and steel.
It's interesting that when we first looked at it, it was a really visceral reaction. Maybe there was that other underlying theme there that we were actually responding to.
My theory is that if you've got things about global warming and isobars and thermoclines and lots of exciting things happening on the edge, which are sort of rather scientific, and then they morph into this wild, ecstatic, instinctive, celebratory art stuff, you've got a meeting of the two different kinds of ways we think.